Hey guys, have you ever found yourself wondering what's the most appropriate size microSD card for my GoPro? Well, the answer to that question is often a little bit tricky because it depends on frame rate, resolution, bit rate, even your budget. Well, we're going to try to sort all that out for you and help you make the best decision for what's an appropriate size memory card for the way you use your GoPro. So let's go unpack that right now and get into it. All right, we're going to try to help you get an understanding of two fundamental topics here. First of all, to understand how your Hero8 video settings will impact your file sizes. And then, equally importantly, how much memory do you really need to buy? Before we talk about what impacts your file sizes, let's talk about what settings specifically don't affect your file sizes. First of all, the lens setting. From my testing, it doesn't seem that either the narrow, linear, wide, or even super view settings will impact your file size in any significant way. And in addition to that, neither hyper smooth or the boost stabilization seem to impact file size either. So let's look at what settings do affect your file size. Now hold on to your hats here. This is a bit of an eye chart, but bear with me. So on this chart, you'll see on the left-hand side, the most important things affecting file size are obviously resolution and the frames per second. Now, in all of these cases, I just used a wide angle setting on the lens just because it didn't really make any difference and I just wanted it to be consistent. Now, the next major thing that can definitely dramatically affect your file size is the bit rate. Now, the low bit rate on the Hero8 equates to 60 megabits per second. And the high bitrate setting equates to 100 megabits per second. The other thing that can have a significant impact on your file size is the compression method. Now, by default, the GoPro Hero8 is set up to use both the H.264 and HEVC compression as appropriate. And essentially what it does is it applies HEVC compression at the highest frame rate for each resolution type. And for everything else, it uses H.264. Now, you can specify in your GoPro settings to use specifically the HEVC compression only for everything, and it will get you about a 25% reduction in file size as compared to H.264. But keep in mind that HEVC is a more aggressive compression, and it may impact your overall video quality. So let's look at a couple of things. Doubling the frame rate with the same resolution will typically increase your file size by about 50%. Until you get to the highest frame rate, and then it holds steady at about the same file size as the previous frame rate, but that is because of the HEVC compression. And going from low to high bit rate will generally increase your file size by 30 to 50% for the 1080p resolutions, and for both 2K and 4K, the difference in file size is about 67% increase, with a notable exception of 2.7K at 30 frames, which for some reason will increase the file size by a whopping 233% over the same resolution with a low bitrate. Now, I'm not sure why it's so dramatic in that particular case. It's also very interesting that 2.7K at 30 frames produces pretty much the same file sizes as 1080p at 30 frames. In addition, 2.7K at 30 frames and 2.7K at 60 frames produce roughly the same file sizes at high bitrate setting. So, I don't really have an explanation for these particular anomalies. I did double and triple test the results to make sure that I hadn't made a mistake here. So if anyone else has any insights or theories as to why these particular oddities are as they are, please leave those in the comments below. So armed with all this information, let's talk about how this translates into how much memory you really need. So to make the next table as simple as I possibly could, I decided to make an assumption that 4K 30 frames a second using the default compression of H.264 was probably a safe bet. So based on that, let's have a look. A 32 gig microSD card, after it's formatted, will give you about 1 hour of video time at a low bit rate. And at a high bit rate, you'll get about 36 minutes. Now you can simply double these numbers when you go to 64 gigabyte, 128 gigabyte, and 256 gigabyte. I won't read the whole table for you. You can obviously read it for yourself. Now, these time storage values are close approximations, and they do take into account the formatted capacity of each microSD card. So another thing to understand is that all microSD cards are not created equally. So what does that mean? So looking at the GoPro website, they actually give you this little graphic here that shows that Lexar versus SanDisk. So the important takeaway from this graphic is that you either use the class 10 designator, as is on the Lexar card with the large C with the 10 inside, or the U with the 1 inside, which designates a class 1 UHS designation. GoPro says that in either case, as long as there is the UHS class 1 designator, you can be reasonably sure that these cards will be compatible with all of their cameras. Now the SanDisk Extreme is the one that GoPro is currently shipping with their GoPro Hero 8. But there are multiple flavors of SanDisk Extreme. Let's take a look at that real quick. So you can see, in addition to the Extreme, there's the Extreme Plus and the Extreme Pro. There's also a SanDisk Ultra, which is not on this table. The important thing here is to understand that the thing we're most interested in is the minimum write speed and maximum write speed. As you can see, all of these give you a minimum write speed of 30 megabytes per second. And in all these cases, that's sufficient for GoPro's current Hero technology. Now, if you want a little bit of future proof in your memory card purchase, it might make sense to buy either the SanDisk Extreme Plus or the Extreme Pro. And as you can see, the Plus gives you 60 megabytes max write, whereas the Pro gives you 90 megabytes max write. So that higher maximum write speed could buy you a little bit of a performance advantage as technologies improve. So I hope you found the information helpful. I sure learned a few things while I was trying to put this information together for you. Once you start buying more memory cards, they are kind of easy to lose track of because they are so small. So you might consider getting some kind of a case to hold them in. This one's kind of cool. It's waterproof. I'll leave a link to this in the description section below in case you're interested in checking it out. It's pretty inexpensive, but as you can see, it holds the adapters of, you know, the full-size SD adapters and the microSD as well. Really handy. So it'd be great if you considered subscribing. We'd love to have you join our small and growing community. So thanks for watching, and go have some fun outdoors.